godly fruit, you have to wonder, are you really saved? Because the whole part of sanctification is changing, and change hurts, and it's hard, and it's not about sitting in these chairs here and being comfortable. I mean, you should want to be in a church that makes you a little bit uncomfortable about the way you're living, or maybe something you can be doing better, or, you know, we should be constantly striving to be more for God. Because quite frankly, it's not about us, it's about God. Because without God, we wouldn't even be here. And worship is what sets all of that up. And I was raised in a Christian church and kind of, you know, wandered away and was backslidden for many, many years. And you know, worship is an extremely personal thing, but it's also something that sometimes we have to force ourselves to start doing. And it's uncomfortable at times. You know, you're sitting here and you're raising your hands and you're like, who's watching and what are people thinking? We gotta get past that, because quite frankly, it's not about anybody else. It's about you and God. And when you're worried about what everybody else is thinking about what you're doing, you lose the whole point of worship. And, you know, my dad is an old timer, and it makes him extremely uncomfortable to be in church, and he's like, not at all about worship. But it all begins with worship. And that's what keeps us in that vertical with God, is the worship. And it's not about whether we feel like doing it. It's doing it, and then as the more we do it, the more we're gonna feel like doing it. And you know, even up there in this conference of leadership people, and they were singing, and they had the Walk in the Word band and the Vertical Church band, and even in the leaders of the church, there's still a lack of true adoration and worship. As I kind of was there and I watched as worship was playing, and in all songs, you know, the chorus is usually one and everybody will raise their hands and then they drop down and the rest of it. We really should be praising God through the whole song. We should be singing songs that are about praising God and the wonderfulness of God, and not about the soft, ooey-gooey stuff. And this church is meant to be a vertical church. It's about us and God. And you know, the rest of it, it's going to work out on its own. And we need to be about the Father's business. And David, in Psalms 96, says, "Oh, sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Sing to the Lord. Bless his name. Tell of his salvation from day to day. Declare his glory among the nations, his marvelous works among all the peoples. For great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised. He is to be feared above all gods, for all the gods of the people are worthless idols. But the Lord made the heavens. Splendor and majesty are before him. Strength and beauty are in his sanctuary." Everything that we see is because God has given it and created it and allowed it to be made. And we need to be praising God all the time. If you're struggling, praise him in your struggles and see everything change. And so today I challenge you to really enter into a worship of praise to God. Close your eyes. Let it be between you and God. You don't have to know what the words of the songs say. Just let it be between you and God, and don't worry about what everybody else around you is doing. Let it be between you and God, and enter in from the very beginning, and don't wait until there's that one song that you really love that makes you feel all joy and happy. Because that stuff, you know, that's emotion, as Pastor said many times. We want true. God wants true love for him and true worship of him, regardless of our warm and fuzzies that we get from a song. Dear Lord Jesus, I thank you, Lord, so much for this church and for each and every individual person here. I thank you, Lord, that you are growing this church to be a church that is a vertical church, a church that is for you, Lord, that it's not about what the world wants, Lord, but what you want. I ask that you bless this worship time and that you work within each one of us, Lord, to draw us closer to you. I ask this in your mighty and powerful name. Amen.
To eye, open the eyes of the Please. Author of salvation, and here